to this fourth lecture of Multivariable Calculus. Myself, Professor F.M. Chincholi, Arts, Science and Commerce College, Manmad. In the previous lecture, we have learned the existence of limit of functions of two variables and the non-existence of limit of functions of two variables. The objectives of this lecture are to study the continuity of the functions of two variables. Continuity of a function. A function f of two variables, say x and y, is called continuous at ordered pair AB if limit xy approaches to AB of f of xy is equal to f of AB. Note that this ordered pair AB must be in the domain of F so that the value f of AB exists. And f is continuous at AB if and only if whenever the ordered pair xy approaches to ordered pair AB, its images f of xy approaches towards the value f of AB. Means whenever the distance between ordered pair xy and AB becomes very very small, the distance between the values f of xy and f of AB are also as small as possible. We say that a function f is continuous on D if f is continuous at every point on that set D. Continuity of a polynomial function. We know that a polynomial function of two variables or polynomial is the sum of terms of the form c times x raised to n into y raised to n, where c is a constant and x and y are non-negative integers. Note that a polynomial function is always continuous in one variable as well as in two variables. A polynomial function is continuous everywhere in this two variable also. Example, evaluate limit of the polynomial x square y cube minus x cube y square plus 3x plus 2y as order pair xy approaches to order pair AB. Since f of xy is equal to x square y cube minus x cube y square plus 3x plus 2y is a polynomial function, it is continuous everywhere. So we can find the limit by direct substitution. As it is continuous, what we can say? Limit of xy approaches to AB, f of xy is equal to f of AB. In the place of AB, if I substitute order pair 1, 2, what we get? Limit of f of xy as xy approaches to 1, 2 is equal to f of 1, 2. Now we have to just substitute this polynomial in the place of f of xy and substitute the order pair 1, 2 in this polynomial so as to get limit xy tends to 1, 2 of the polynomial x square y cube minus x cube y square plus 3x plus 2y is equal to, now to just substitute x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2 here. So as to get 1 square into 2 cube minus 1 cube into 2 square plus 3 into 1 plus 2 into 2. 2 cube is 8 into 1 is 8. 2 square is 4 into 1 is 4. Means it will be 8 minus 4 plus 3 plus 4. and after simplifying it, we will get the value of limit xy approaches to 1 to of x square y cube minus x cube y square plus 3x plus 2y is equal to 11. Second example, where is the function f of xy is equal to x square minus y square upon x square plus y square continuous? The function f of xy is equal to x square minus y square upon x square plus y square, it is a quotient of two polynomials. Numerator is a polynomial function x square minus y square, and denominator it is also a polynomial function x square plus y square. Therefore, numerator and denominator are everywhere continuous function. And therefore, this quotient of polynomial functions, it is called as a rational function. It is a rational function. So, it is again continuous everywhere except at those points for which denominator is 0. Means we can say that this function is discontinuous at 0, 0. Why it is discontinuous at 0, 0? Because at the point 0, 0, denominator becomes 0 square plus 0 square is equal to 0. Means at this point, the value of function does not exist. Means this point is not in the domain of function. As it is not in the domain of function, it is not continuous. Function is not continuous at the point 0, 0. While as it is a rational function, means quotient of polynomials, it is continuous everywhere in its domain. So what we get? F is a rational function, therefore it is continuous on its domain, and its domain contains all order pairs of real number except 0, 0. Therefore it is continuous in the set D is equal to set of order pairs xy belongs to R2 such that xy is not equal to order pair 0, 0. Example 3. Let g of xy is equal to x square minus y square upon x square plus y square if order pair xy is not equal to 0, 0. And it is equal to 0 if order pair xy is equal to 0, 0. Discuss the continuity of C. The function g of xy is equal to quotient function x square minus y square upon x square plus y square for xy not equal to 0, 0. As it is a quotient function of polynomials, similar as previous example, it is continuous everywhere on R2 except at the point 0, 0. But the reason in this example for the discontinuity of G at the origin 0, 0 is different, because origin 0, 0 is in the domain of G and its value at the origin is given to be 0. But if we find the limit of g of xy as xy tends to 0, 0, it does not exist. We have taken such example in the previous lecture. If we take a path y is equal to mx which passes through the origin, we can observe that limit of g of xy as xy tends to 0, 0 along such a path y is equal to mx is 1 minus m square upon 1 plus m square, which depends on m, and therefore limit does not exist. Since it is a rational function, it is continuous on its domain except at 0, 0. Since limit of g of xy as xy tends to 0, 0 does not exist. Example 4, let h of xy is equal to 3x square y upon x square plus y square if xy is not equal to 0, 0, and it is equal to 0 if xy is equal to 0, 0. discuss the continuity of h. Since h of xy is equal to 3x square y upon x square plus y square, it is again quotient of two polynomials. Therefore, it is a rational function and it is continuous everywhere except at those points for which denominator becomes 0. Means except at the 0, 0. Means here only we have to check the continuity of function h at the origin 0, 0. Whether h is continuous at origin or not. As it is a rational function, it is continuous on its domain, which is the set d is equal to the set of xy belongs to R2, xy is not equal to 0, 0. Now, for this particular function, 0, 0 is not in its domain. But when we add the second case together with this function, that is h of xy is equal to 0 for order pair xy is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0 becomes the point in the domain of h. Now we can observe along the every path limit of h of xy as xy tends to 0, 0 is 0 itself. And it equals to h of 0, 0. Means function h of xy is also continuous at the point 0, 0. See, this condition is very bad. Limit of h of xy as xy tends to 0, 0 becomes equals to h of 0, 0. Therefore, h becomes continuous at the point 0, 0 also. And therefore, now the function h is continuous everywhere in the set of ordered pairs of real numbers, that is R2. So it is continuous on its domain R. Example 5. Where is the function h of xy is equal to arctan y upon x continuous? Arctan is nothing but the inverse function of tan. The function f of xy is equal to y upon x. It is again a rational function. Therefore, it is continuous everywhere except at those points for which denominator is 0. Means except at the order pair xy for which x is equal to 0. The function f of xy is equal to y upon x is a rational function. And therefore, it is continuous except on the line x is equal to 0. Another function, g of t is equal to arctan of t, that is the tan inverse of t. It is also continuous everywhere along the real line. So the composition of these two continuous functions, g of f of xy is equal to, what is f of xy? F of xy is y upon x. Therefore, g of f of xy becomes g of y upon x. But what is g of t? G of t is arctan of t. Therefore, g of y upon x becomes arctan of y upon x. Therefore, this composite function g of f of xy is equal to arctan of y upon x. It is also continuous everywhere except on the line x is equal to 0. Therefore, this function h of xy is equal to arctan y upon x is continuous everywhere in R2 except the line x is equal to 0. Assignment. In the comment box of this YouTube video, there is a link of Google form of feedback cum assignment. For any query, please write a comment in the comment box. Thank you. If you like this video, please click on the like symbol. If you want to share it, please click on the share symbol. And for the further alert of next videos, subscribe this channel. Note that for doing any of this activity, you have to log in with your Google account.